students, today I'll be starting with the B part of question number 1. Now in this part we have calculate the amount and compound interest on rupees 18,000 for 2.5 years at 10% per annum compounded annually. So here this 18,000 is the principal, this is the number of year and this is the rate of interest. Okay, now compounded annually means we will have to find the interest once in a year. So here principal is rupees 18,000, rate of interest is 10% and number of year is 2.5 years compounded annually. Okay, so the formula for finding amount is P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power N. Now here P is the principal, R is the rate of interest and N is the number of year. Now here we always write the whole number. Now see here 2.5. So what should I do here? How to find the amount? We will write this whole number in place of N and we will find this half year afterwards. Okay, so if the number of years is given in mixed fraction, then using this formula we will find the amount for the 2 years and the rest half years we will find under SI. Okay, so we are finding amount for 2 years. So in place of P, we'll write 18,000 into 1 plus R is 10 by 100 to the power N. In place of N, we will put the whole number. Here, this is in whole number, so we'll write 2. Okay. Now, 0, 0, we will cancel it. So we have 18,000 into 1 plus 1 by 10. Whole to the power 2. Now 18,000 into 10 into 1 is 10. Now 10 divided by 1 is 10. 10 into 1 is 10 plus 10 divided by 10 is 1. 1 into the numerator is 1. Whole to the power 2. So 18,000 into 10 plus 1 is 11 by 10 whole to the power 2. Now here power is 2, so 18,000 will be multiplied by 11 by 10 multiplied by 11 by 10. We have written this 11 by 10 2 times as power is 2. Okay, now we'll cancel the zeros. 0 0 we can cancel, 0 0 we can cancel. So we have 180 multiplied by 11 multiplied by 11. So 11 11 is a 121. So 180 multiplied by 121 is 10 is a 0, 81 is a 8, 11 is a 1, 20 is a 0, 82 is a 16, 21 is a 2, then 3, then multiplying by 1, 10 is a 0, 81 is a 8, 11 is a 1. So it's the 8 plus 0 is 8, then 6 plus 1 is 7, 8 plus 3 is 11, 1 carry, 1 plus 1, 2. So we have rupees 21,780. So this is the amount for the 2 years. Now, this would act as principal for the next half year. Okay, so we will find SI on rupees 18,000 for half years. So SI for half years is, so how to find SI? It's P into R into T divided by 100. So principal is this one, 21,780. Now what will be the rate of interest? Rate of interest will remain same. It will be this and time will be this, 1 by 2. Now here in the denominator we have 100, so it is 100 multiplied by 2. Now 0 0 we can cancel it, 0 0 we can cancel it. Now 2 ones are 2, 2 ones are 2, 1 cannot be divided by 2, so it's 0. Then 2 8s are 16, then 2 9s are 18. So it's rupees 1089. Now here SI is used for finding half year. Okay, now why we have used SI here? Because we know that SI and CI is same for the first year, isn't it? So that's why we can find using SI. So here this is the interest for half year. Now we will have to find the total amount which you will have to pay after 2.5 years. So total amount will be 2.5 years. Now how to find the amount? See, this is the amount for the 2 years. So this and this interest to be added to this amount to get the amount to be paid after 2.5 years. So it's 21780 plus 1089 to get the amount to be paid after 2.5 years. Okay, so 21780 plus 1089. So 9 plus 0 is 9, 8 plus 8 is 16, 1 carry, 7 plus 1 is 8, 1 plus 1 2 is 2. So it's rupees 22,869. So this is the total amount. Now we will have to pay. Now we will have to find the compound interest. So CI will be amount minus principal, isn't it? So amount is this 22,869 and principal is 18,000. This is the principal. Now if you subtract principal from the amount, then we will get compound interest. So 22,869 minus 18,000. So 22869 - 18,000. So 9 - 0 is 9, 6 - 0 is 6, 8 - 0 is 8, 12 - 8 is 4. So 2 will be 1. So 1 - 1 is 0. So the compound interest is 4869. Okay. So this was part number B. Thank you, students.